When I'm Jordi Aragunde, I'm head delegate of Catalonian Ports here in Spanish state. I'm a member of La Coordinadora, that is the union that represents around the 90% of the dock workers of Spain.
And what are the issues facing dock workers here in Spain and in Europe?
Now in Spain we have a very little problem or big problem, that is that the European Commission have made a reasoned opinion about the law in Spain that put in problems to the rest of to all the dock workers, to the pool dock workers, because they say that there are not obligations from the companies to go to the pool of workers to search the people for work. It means that what they are trying to defend is like in other countries of Europe, like Greece, like Portugal, like Italy, that they come and company like Costco or MSC or Hutchinson and can bring their own personnel and can work with rights and with Asiatic conditions, like happens in the port of Pireo now in Greece.
And how does it affect the workers if they bring in untrained workers to work on the docks and they bring in just people off the street to work as a longshoreman? What happens?
We have the example in Portugal. We have a port like that is seen as that they have personal, not training personal, not with formation, that they are having a lot of accidents, very low productivity, but they are cheaper, of course. Yeah, they have no formation, no training, but they have a very low salary, and this is the main objective of the companies and of the European government.
And this deregulation and privatization, how are they pushing that in Greece? How is that affecting dock workers in Europe? Deregulation and privatization. They're trying to change the rules and allow. Why was the International Dock Workers Council, and what is it, and how was it formed, and why was it formed? International Dock Workers.
Okay, the IDC was founded 14 years ago, in 2000. This finally is some important countries begin to see that the conflicts are beginning, global conflicts, it begins to be not only in the local and national issues, if not, there are European Commission, there are the big ship owners make alliance to come fight against the rights of the dock workers. And the people in this moment say that we have to have an council and union that can defend the rights of all the dock workers of the world. The reality is that it's the conclusion after a battle that we lose. It's the battle of the Liverpool dock workers, where 500 dock workers were sacked in 1995. And this is the result of this loose battle who make to us, to the workers, to make a new movement to can defend the rights of the dock workers.
So you're saying the lessons of the Liverpool dock struggle was that you had to have a new organization that would actually fight actively in a different way.
I'm sure that if now it happens, the conflict of Liverpool, the struggle, we will win. And it's what we have not in the past. And now I think that it will make a very good work for can join a lot of countries and all the people that have a position of decision are the workers. We have no inspectors that live for know what's happening in the places and don't work in the port. We have the people that go to the meeting, like myself, like Kenneth, are people that live in the port. It's not people that live in the capital, in other places, that don't know what's happening in the day-to-day of the work.
Now, what role did the Spanish dock workers and Barcelona dock workers play in the struggle in Charleston, South Carolina of ILA 1422?
They were
What role? I mean, what, yes. You built solidarity with them and yes. You took action. And
okay, our solidarity with the Charleston struggle was clear. We say that the first ship that comes from Charleston and with the loading and unloading made by scraps, we don't work. And we wait all the night hoping that comes, waiting that comes the Lordana ship, Lordana line ship. We wait in a 20 feet containers empty in was on winter and cloudy day, cloudy night. And we wait that comes the ship to stop and to say to the ship owner that when they have an successful for our guys for the conflict, we continue working.
And what happened?
And they take the decision that
they decided to make an agreement with.
They decided to make an agreement with the Charleston dock workers that are our colleagues.
And as a result of that, the Charleston longshoremen supported IDC and the ILA. Why don't you talk about
that? This was one of the big important issues that makes that ILA and especially Charleston ILA comes IDC and put a lot of power to the council. And that for us was very important. The North American people joined IDC of East Coast, also West Coast, of South America, Brazil, of Europe, France, Spain, a lot of countries.
What is your relationship of the longshore workers to other struggles going on in the unions?
That are happening today.
Yeah.
Today in Europe we have two or three very big strikes that we are taking today, that is in Portugal with the regulation and with the new creation of second pools in the ports. Second pools with training, with health and safety are another kind of regulation with the deregulation of the docker rights. We have the privatization of the Port Authority of El Pireo, that is another conflict that is for us very important. And after of this is the big situation that is the European Commission, who are trying to make directives or opinions about the rights of the dock workers to can limit the work of the dock workers. That is their main objective. We have two directives in the past, in 2000. The truth is that we have a lot of relation with all the sectors of workers because we are dock workers and we try to fight against the austerity
measures
that are happening today in Europe. They are trying to profit. There's this crisis that there are in the south of Spain, in the south of Europe, trying to deregulation of the rights of the workers, putting the retirement until the more of 70 years in Greece, in Spain, in Portugal, in Italy. And we are trying to organize a new movement, not only in Europe, if not in the world, for defend the workers' rights. We have, I think that the dockers especially have to take a very important power and powerful and position in this fight.
And there have been big strikes, struggles here in Spain. There was a general strike. Why don't you talk about the movement here in the working class in Spain and to fight austerity and to fight the economic policies of capitalism here in Spain?
I am, my point of view, I'm very critical with the unions, the general unions in Spain, because they have sold his rights to the government. They are normally have a lot of affiliation, really have a lot of affiliation, but they make the strikes in Sunday, that is when anybody works, and they make a manifestation or a demonstration the Sundays at 6 of the afternoon, that there are not so many people. And there are very close relations between the employers, the big association of employers, and the government, with the unions. I am not syndicalist, no?
Syndicalism.
I'm not syndicalism. In Spain, the word of that you are a syndicalist is it have a bad, no? Una mala
connotation.
Bad connotation.
A bad connotation. And I prefer say I'm a dog worker, I work for our council. We are very clear, we have the things clear, we have to work to defend the dockers' rights and try to help to other sectors, but in the way that they are putting the strategy, the big unions of FUGT or Comisiones Obreras that traditionally were people combative of the communes, of marches, of they have a very powerful. And what is today that they bring Rolex in their hands, they go with their ship, and this is not the...
They're like business people.
This is what not represent the working class, and we are not in this way.
In your view, is that why the struggle has been unsuccessful? That these unions aren't using the real power that they have? They don't really want to fight?
Yeah, really, because if we have... Here in Spain, we are 6,000 dock workers affiliation, and when we win the previous law in Spain, all the lobbies appears in the news saying the power of 6,000 dock workers win to the parliament, to the Spanish parliament. I cannot imagine if we have, like they have, 1 million or 500 million of personal affiliation, we can stop the economy. We can say to the Spanish government, it not depends on the color, it can be of the left, right, or the left, or the right. In Spain, are the same, the left or and the right. There are not a very combative politician. They are in the same way. It's a pity, but it's the truth.
Well, it seems like in the United States, disparity of wealth, very rich, 1%,
yeah.
And the mass of people are being pauperized, becoming poorer and poorer.
Yeah, it's the same.
It's the same thing in Spain?
It's the same in Spain. They're at least the same.
So it seems like some people are doing very well in Spain.
Yeah.
And the working class is hurting.
Yeah, the working class is in the same position. I don't know why the big unions don't make strikes every week, because every week we are seeing like people that can have food for it, younger boys that cannot go to the school, and we have not go to Africa. It happens here in Barcelona. We have big ships, we have Messi, we have a lot of things in Barcelona, but we have a lot of people that is having a lot of problems, and it's the consequence of the austerity measures of the government.
And how is privatization policies affecting Spain? Are they trying to privatize education, or how is the government implementing austerity concretely in Spain?
In Spain, one of the things that they are trying to take the privatization was the health that is a thing that is very important for us, because we pay a lot of money of bills to the government to take public health, and they are changing the model. They are making that all the people that have a little of money pay a private health, and you can, if you have an operation of your knee or any problem with your hair, you can operate in 1, 2, or 1 week. In the normal health now, you have to wait 6 months, 10 months, and this is one of the issues that is a very issue for that the unions, the Socialist Party, take a position, say no to the austerity measures, to take one position. You cannot say, okay, yes, it's okay for us. It's the people dying for the bad health. Yeah, okay. And this is one of the things that we see.
Now, the role of the United States, U.S. government, and World Bank, IMF, is to impose austerity. Also, I mean, militarization. Where does your union and IDC stand on in issues of the military and U.S. military intervention in, like, Ukraine or in other countries? You know, that's
like our union here in Barcelona. We have an active position with the situation because we have our we can mark our position in Spain in the level of the state. We cannot consider these kind of things because we are a lot of people and every people have one position. We can speak about some issues and you can put a problem on the top. But here in Barcelona we are conscious of the situation. We have participated with the freedom ship of the ship of the freedom that goes to Gaza. We have participated against the situation with the Palestinian workers and citizens. We are against the militarization of the situation in Ukraine. We are in this side, of course. We are workers. We are seeing what is happening and what is happening is that USA, Russia, they are trying to take the petrol, the oil there, and this is finally their main objective. And this is one thing that anybody wants to say, but this is what happened. And Obama, it was the president that all we believe that can change the situation in the United States, but we say that Guantanamo continues in function. There are the same situation, and it's difficult. It's difficult because I think that we are in a moment that the capitalist is winning the war. Is winning the war against the working class. The working class is more worried about if I can live. I am quiet. I have no problems. I have my car, my flat, my wife. I have his private health, and we have no problem. But when you see that every time we are less, is that the capitalist is winning this war, and we don't want to see, and this is the truth. We are in the middle of a battle, and the working class are not putting a pressure, a position strong.
So we're in a class war, a class struggle all over the world.
Yes,
which is growing bigger and bigger.
Yes, I totally agree. I'm sure that there are a very, very big war, and we are losing now.
And do you see hope as far as workers becoming more aware, unions becoming more aware that they have to fight differently than in the past?
No.
Now, today, I mean, our workers beginning to wake up.
Yeah.
And trade unions, we have to fight differently. We have to fight organized differently.
Yeah, now with the situation in Korea, like that we participate in the rally of San Francisco, we see that there are people that think in this situation that they are the first strikes. We have the situation with the dockers in Hong Kong that also they stay a lot of days in a strike. Now are people in South Africa also making strikes for can recognize his rights, and we are seeing green, I don't know which is spelling in English, but it's
revitalization.
Yes,
revitalization.
Yeah. And young people also of South Africa, of Hong Kong, here in Spain, they are changing things, and we hope that it will be the principle of the change of this model of work.
And IDC is starting to grow and getting more support around the world. What's happened in England at Liverpool? Are the dock workers starting to organize in England?
In England, as you know, IDC began after lose the conflict of Liverpool because we don't exist and the other big union, ITF, don't make the answer that it happens in the moment. Now, with the time, 3 or 4 years ago, we put in contact with the people of Liverpool Dockers that was sacked in the past, and they proposed try to organize another time the union in all United Kingdom. They are people that wants to fight against the politicians of the past, of Margaret Thatcher. Laws that makes in the past that they are very limited with the strikes, with the fight, but they are trying to change and trying to fight another time. We have affiliation now in three or four parts of England. We have possibly in Ireland, in North Ireland also. We stayed 1 month ago in Belfast with the dog workers also, and we are seeing that there are revival also of the situation.
So your union, your federation, IDC, also affiliates with individual ports, not just national unions, individual?
No, we have, the more clear example is ILA. We affiliate Charleston ILA, Bahamas ILA. Now, 2 years ago, we affiliate all the ILA to all the East Coast, but we have no problems in affiliate unions because we are not a union. IDC is not a federation. It's a council. It's the International Dog Workers Council. There are dog workers, a council from dog workers for dog workers. We have not any. I don't work in IDC. I work in the port, and if I have to take a meeting, like 1 month ago in Portugal, I will go to Portugal. We have the meeting with the government, but I go like a dog worker on IDC.
And in the Portugal struggle, your IDC has supported them, and also they have video. How is the IDC or the Portugal dock workers using media communication technology to get their story out?
Quite quickly, what happens in Portugal was the government make a law 3 years ago. They begin to put the law in functioning. This is it's the normal that it makes in every country. And we were trying to make good the law. We know that there are very bad things, but we are trying to make good. After a lot of struggles of problems inside, especially in the port of Lisboa, that they are trying to put another pool and try to substitute the dockers of the first pool, of the historical pool, to the second, IDC begin a new movement, for say this moment, of actions of solidarity. We begin stopping the ships that goes and come and goes from Portugal with Spain. That was the biggest action, because when Spain to ports as important like Algeciras or Valencia or Barcelona, you say, this ship, where come from Lisbon? Because these containers that come from Lisbon, they stay in the ship because we don't discuss. It's when the conflict it becomes more international. We also make 3 hours of stoppage January this year for explain to all the assemblies of Europe what are happening there. And we go to the embassies to speak with every country embassies to explain the situation, to say that this is the first, that if we have not successful, we will stop in all the world the cargo and that comes from Portugal. Also, we put in contact with the customer in origin, that normally is Brazil, with the customer of Brazil, and explain that if the situation don't have unsuccessful, IDC will propose to all the affiliates to stop off the cargo of the ships of the world. And this is a situation that is the only way that the employers know. You can speak English, you can speak Spanish, but when you stop a ship, they understand at first. No, it's not necessary to speak more. And this is what we make. We have especially a ship that goes to Algeciras. We stop at 36 hours in the port until they make a letter to the Portuguese government, saying that they don't want to work with dog workers that were not training, if not with the historical dog workers. And they make a little way of negotiation that, like IDC, myself, especially will stay with the dockers of Portugal and could make an agreement.
So you're building solidarity by direct action.
Yeah, sure.
Because the direct using your power.
We have two models of make solidarity. The solidarity letters that there are other international unions that they are very often we will send a letter everybody. But finally, the letters are what are. They are a paper that normally anybody reads. And they are the other part that it may must be action. Action is the only thing that they understand. Is make an action, stop, and have to get the things clear. And in this case, especially of Portugal, IDC, and I think that the dockers class needs a victory, because we were seeing like in Greece we have problems and it's very difficult because the situation of the crisis is difficult to take an agreement there. Italy also problems, in Cyprus also problems, in Africa also problems, and we must to IDC need a win, and it's what we do this first part of the year when we take the agreement.
And in Greece, there have been privatization of the ports, and the Chinese investors have taken over some ports. What's happened in these ports in Greece where the Chinese investors have taken over and privatized the ports?
Okay, the truth is that in Greece, the Chinese investors are trying to buy the port, but also are trying to buy the Acropolis and trying to buy the Agora, and with the big budget that they have, that because they have a very big debt to Germany, and the debt that they have in the country, they are in the obligation of sell everything that they have. This is a pity, but it's what they are selling us. They are saying, oh, we have to sell everything, and we have to finish with all the rights of the dock workers, because it's very important for the customer, for the Chinese. It's difficult to the situation. We are working very hard to can attend meetings with Costco Group, that is the ship owner that is working there, to can take a middle position that we can get successful. But we know that it will be difficult because.
So the Chinese calls itself a socialist country, you know, communist country. Yet it seems like, for European dock workers, like in Greece, the Chinese investment is not helping the Greek working class.
Yeah. It's the contradictory, no? It's that I am communist in my home, but when I go out, I go, or it's like everyone, no? Like yourself, myself, that I am communist party, I'm a socialist, but I go to Bahamas, to the beach, in the six stars hotel to relax. I think that not in the correct way, no? They're things that are not normal. And this situation with the Costco, that have a very important participation of the Chinese government, it's contradictory with the Socialist Party, with the Communist Party that stay in the government. But finally, it's a capitalist class, working class.
So it is a class struggle. It's capitalists trying to make profit off of.
Sure. In fact, it's money. Funny, we are speaking about money, not speaking about rights. They are communists, but they are first is the money. This is the new communists of the world.
Okay. Are you optimistic about the future of the working class, the dock workers, and the future of the world working class?
I am. I'm worried because I see that the battle is true, that there are things that are changing, because I think I see young people, the thing of Hong Kong, the docks of Hong Kong, it's a very important thing. Australia also, the struggle was a very important thing. In South Africa now that they are fighting for their rights, this is important, but after I see the European Commission with a lot of power, Germany, with a lot of power, United Kingdom, that are traditionally countries that their ideology are against the dock workers, against the rights of the people. And this is, I think that I am worried but prepared. I think that the, especially the Docker's class, I think that we are prepared. In the West Coast, there are a lot of combative locals, like the local of Oakland, for me and for the Dockers of Barcelona, are the model of the syndicalists in here in Barcelona and in Europe. There are this, especially this local, I think that they are a model for everybody. Also, there are in Latin America, in South America, there are also countries combative, like in Chile, in Argentina, that they are working very hard. In the East Coast also, then the team of New Jersey also, of Charleston, of course, Bahamas. I think that there are a lot of moments and we have to coordinate better. We have to try to put in contact East Coast, people of Hong Kong, and make a very big movement that all are in the same ocean, say in Hong Kong in the struggle. It's true, we are all in the same ocean and we must to fight together, and this is the only way to win. And this is all.